So in this video, we're going to go through some basic stretches to help improve your flexibility for golf, particularly for the senior golfer. We're going to look at the hips, trunk, shoulders and wrists. Okay, here we go. Shoulder stretch. So I'm going to use a baton, you can use a golf club or something similar. Thumb on top, one hand on top, and all you're going to do is assist with the other hand, okay, pressing your arm backwards, okay, stretching down this shoulder, keeping your arm in nice and close to your ear, okay, and not overextending through the back as well. Okay, so holding that position exactly the same the other side, I'm going to hold each stretch for about 30 seconds. And just using this hand at the bottom to just assist with the stretch. And you want to feel this stretch around the shoulder, okay, down through the lats, through the armpits as well. Next stretch is going to be a hip flexor stretch. So we're going to pop down onto one knee. I'm going to use the dumbbell balance. Big step forwards, okay, hips driving forward. So you should feel this down the front of this downwards leg or this back leg. Stay nice and tall with the upper body, okay, again, the arch and back. Stay nice and tall with this position here. Again, 30 seconds, then we'll swap sides. Again, feeling it down the front of this back leg. Next one is an open book. Okay, so I'm going to pop down onto our side. I'm just going to use the ball to pop my knee on top here. You can roll up a towel, use a pillow, something like that. Just keep the knee in place. Onto your side, hands on top of each other. All you're going to do is open up round. Okay, and get down towards the floor behind you. Okay, you might not get near it to begin with. So nice and controlled movement this one. And instead of holding for 30 seconds, we're just gonna move into the position and slowly move back out. And then we've gotta do the same the other side as well. So popping down onto your side. You could also put something under your head as well, which can make it a little more comfortable for your neck. So, knee up nice and high, in line with the hips, okay, onto the ball, and then open up behind. So next exercise is cat dogs. Great one for spine mobility, also for posture and just general awareness of where your back is or where your posture is. So we're going to pop down to all fours, hands and knees. Hands below your shoulders and knees below your hips. What we're going to do is arch your whole back and look up. Then you're going to push your back up, tuck your chin in and bum under. And then move slowly from one position to the next. So extending the whole spine and then flexing. So nice and smooth from one side. You might find that it's really tricky to begin with. You might find that you've got hardly any movement. But hopefully over time you'll improve your mobility, posture and just general awareness of where your back is. Lastly, we're going to do a trio of wrist exercises or wrist stretches. So first off, flexion and extension. So arm out in front, I'm just using the other hand to assist. We're just going to do each of these for 10 seconds. Okay, flexion, extension for 10. Same the other side, so flexion. And then into extension. We're going to do pronation and supination next. So elbows resting by the sides, okay, make it a fist, thumbs up. You're going to point your thumbs together and then away, together and then away, and then just keep moving in and out. Okay, so we're looking at supination, pronation, supination, pronation. Okay, bit of rotation around the forearms. Then we're going to do radial and ulnar deviation, so cocking and uncocking. Okay, if you think back swing, okay, cocking and uncocking through the ball. The same as sort of we've gone into that sort of supination and pronation, and exactly the opposite with the lead hand, okay, we're pronating and then supinating as we come through the ball, or hopefully something like that. Anyway, depending on what your swing style is, depending on what you're trying to do with the golf club or golf swing in general. Okay, what was we doing? We're radiant on a deviation. Okay, so again, same sort of position as we just did. Elbows resting by the sides, and all we're going to do is down and then up, down and then up. Okay, working on this deviation here at the wrist. Okay, same both sides, of course. And we're looking that we keep a nice, pretty flat wrist and we don't go backwards into extension to try and get this movement. Okay,